Hello everyone, this is CS Divesh Goyal, practicing company secretary from Delhi. Today in this video, we are going to discuss about the process of strike off of a company incorporated under Companies Act. Sometimes I have seen we are confused between the word winding up and the strike off. Both are having different process and different compliances. Winding up is required approval from the NCLT and is a lengthy process. Strike off required approval from the registrar of company is a short process. So whenever it is possible for the companies to close the company through strike off, they will go with the strike off only instead of the winding up of the company. The process and provision of the strike off of company is given under section 248 of the Companies Act. As per section 248, if a company want, they can go for the strike off by the registrar of companies under section 248. But some companies are not allowed to be strike off under section 248. Those companies can be closed only by the winding up process. So let's discuss ki which are the companies which are not allowed to go for the strike off. Listed companies. Companies registered under section 8 company. Companies having charge which are pending for the satisfaction. Company whose application for the compounding is pending. And etc. Some 5 or 6 more type of companies. So these are the companies which are not allowed to be closed by strike off under section 248. These company can be closed only by the winding up process under Companies Act. So strike off process cannot be used for the these type of companies. So then the question arises, what are the grounds for the strike off? If your company is a newly incorporated company and company have not done any business transaction, company has not commenced any business from 1 year from the date of incorporation, in that case you can go for the strike off of the company. But the situation number two, your company is not a newly incorporated company, but your company has not commenced any business in preceding 2 years. If preceding two immediate years, company have not done any business transaction, not commenced any business or operation, then you can go for the strike off with the registrar of company under section 248. Let's discuss the process of strike off under section 248. In the process of strike off, first step number one is calling of board meeting. The board of directors of the company shall call a meeting of the board of directors. In that meeting, they will pass resolutions for the strike off of the company. And second, in the same board meeting, they will call a extraordinary general meeting of the shareholders of the company for the approval of the shareholders. So first step is the calling of board meeting. Second step is holding of extraordinary general meeting. In the second step, company shall hold an extraordinary general meeting and pass a special resolution with the approval of 75% of the shareholder in the general meeting. So in the second step, company will pass a special resolution in general meeting for the strike off of the company. Step number three, company will file e-form MGT 14 within 30 days of passing of special resolution in general meeting. Step number four, company have to prepare the application for the strike off along with some document like NOC from the appropriate concerned authority. If your company is registered with RBI, IRDA, Housing Finance, SEBI, then the company is first required to take NOC from the concerned authority. Second, company will prepare an indemnity bond in STK 3. These indemnity bonds shall be signed by the directors of the company. Third document, statement of account certified by the chartered accountant. This is the most important document. Company have to prepare a statement of account not older than 30 days at the time, 30 days from the filing of the application with ROC. Statement of account should be certified by the chartered accountant. Statement of account should show nil asset and liability. For an example, one side in the balance sheet there is a capital of the 1 lakh, other side there should be losses, so that nil asset and liability statement can be prepared. Nil asset and liability statement is the most important requirement of the provision of the strike off. Next document, affidavits by the director in format STK4. Then certified true copy of the special resolution, copy of the certificate of closure of the bank account. These 7 documents company have to prepare. Then once these 7 document is prepared, in the next step, step number 5, company have to file e-form STK2 with the registrar of company. In e-form STK2, company have to attach all these 7 document. At the time of filing of STK2, company have to pay fees of ₹10,000 as a statutory fees for filing of STK 2. Once the form for the strike of STK 2 is filed, ROC will take approximately 3 to 4 months to analyze the document, to check with any other authority about any liabilities of the company. If a register of company is satisfied with all the documents and everything, then they will issue the certificate of strike off of the company. So this is the process complete for the strike off of company. And except this process, sometimes the questions raised by the professional and the corporate, whether it is mandatory to comply with all the annual filings before strike off of the company. So for this question, we will answer this question in our next video in our YouTube channel. Our complete process, our complete editorial of the process of strike off of the company has already been published on my blog, that is www.csdiveshgoyal.info. So you can subscribe our blog and our YouTube channel for the regular updates on the corporate law. Thank you so much.